Warriors of Chogoris, brothers of the great tribe, the Star Hunt calls you. Do you not hear it? The battle's red edge is your home, the respect of your kinsmen your half. Plunge into the enemy's breast like a blade, cut out his heart, and you will know fulfillment. The Emperor has given us strength. In return, we give him victory.
Of all the sons of the Emperor, a select few have always been viewed with disdain by their brothers. For the Primarchs are the greatest living beings of the Imperium, with exception to the Emperor himself, and their influence across the galaxy molds the Imperium's children to follow. While some are hewn into statues proclaiming their virtues on Imperial worlds, and the fallen Primarchs are worshipped by fell demons, there is one who has always been regarded with suspicion and never truly understood by either loyalist or traitor. Seen by most as a barbarian, this Primarch would in his solitude prove to be well-cultured and intelligent, but keep his intentions and traits closely guarded to prevent them from being exploited. Jaghatai Khan, Primarch of the 5th Legion and Great Khan of Chogoris. During the scattering of the Primarchs, Jaghatai would land on the planet of Chogoris, a fertile world filled with vast plains of grass, snow-topped mountains, and vast oceans. The planet was ruled by the Palatine, a feudal aristocrat whom led his vast armies to dominate the planet. However, there was a land to the west of the Palatine that he would leave wild, the Empty Quarter, a barren grassland with little in resources or value, inhabited by nomadic tribes whom fought amongst themselves for their ancestral lands. This is where Jaghatai would be found by a man by the name of Ong Khan, chieftain of the small tribe of the Kalaskars. Seeing the child as a gift from the gods, Ong would see the fire in Jaghatai's eyes, the mark of a great warrior. Ong was hated by the other tribes of the Empty Quarter for his visions of a united tribe of the downtrodden people of the Empty Quarter. One day, the tribes would kill Jaghatai's adoptive father for his ideals. Even as a boy, Jaghatai was without match as a warrior amongst the men of the Kalaskar tribe, and he would gather his fellow tribesmen to seek vengeance against his father's killers. The Kurayed tribe would be slaughtered, not only the men, but the women and children as well. Jaghatai would cleave the head from the tribe's chieftain and mount it to his sleeping tent. The slaughter would forge Jaghatai into a fiercely ruthless, yet loyal warrior. With his father's death avenged, Jaghatai would swear to unite the people of the Empty Quarter as one tribe and bring an end to its constant infighting. Fighting hundreds of battles for years, Jaghatai would assimilate the warring tribes into the fold, making military service mandatory for all who joined, while splitting the tribe's people amongst themselves to weed out blood feuds and differences within its people. 10 years later, the Khan would travel to his winter settlement and be set upon by the Palatine's hunting bands, led by its emperor's son. Jaghatai would kill the men, leaving one mutilated rider to bring the Palatine emperor the severed head of his son. Enraged, the Palatine would gather a gigantic army to destroy the tribes of the Empty Quarter, but ultimately underestimate Jaghatai. His heavily armored soldiers bested by the Khan's more mobile warriors and archers, the Palatine would retreat, leading to the tribe elders to confer the title of the first Khagan, or Khan of Khans, to Jaghatai. As Jaghatai would continue his conquest, he would recruit soon-to-be legendary members of his future legion, including Kinja, Hasik, and Targutai Yesuge. Besieging the cities of the Palatine, the Khagan would give its inhabitants two choices: surrender or die. Jaghatai would eventually reach the palace of the Palatine. He would demand its emperor's head on a pike from the city, which its inhabitants would willingly oblige. Jaghatai would adorn it on his tent, exactly as he had done to his father's killer 2 decades before. Within 2 years, Jaghatai had conquered Chogoris' largest empire in its history and ended all wars upon the planet's surface. 6 months later, the Emperor would arrive on Chogoris, along with the 16th Legion of Astartes, the Lunar Wolves, and their Primarch, Horus Lupercal. Jaghatai would instantly perceive the Emperor's might, and conclude that his dream of a united species amongst the stars would be possible, even if the Emperor would be at its helm, and not himself. Jaghatai would resign his position of master and become a servant of the Emperor's will, dropping to one knee and swearing fealty to the Emperor and his Imperium. Considering that rejection of the Emperor's will would lead to his people's annihilation, and seeing the Lunar Wolves present, reasoned that these indomitable warriors would soon mirror his own should he swear loyalty to the Imperium. Jaghatai would also hand over the shackles of mundanity that statesmanship required, and would revel in his duty to the Imperium of waging war and hunting the enemies of humanity. Soon he would be given command of his legion, then known as the Star Hunters. Jaghatai would overhaul his Terran-born son's tactics, implementing his Chogoran-learned strategies of speed and maneuverability to best his foes. As the Imperium was desperate for the fighting prowess of all Primarchs, Jaghatai would be sent straight into the Maw of Conflict. With the war against the Nephilim resulting in Jaghatai renaming his sons of the 5th Legion, the Legion would conduct a ritual at the empty quarter of Chogoris, known as the Blooding. 50,000 sons of the Khan would take up blades and cut a mark on the flesh of their faces, inflicting scars that would also herald their individual renaming as Sons of the White Scars. With further battles waged during the Ulanor Crusade against the Orc hordes, Jaghatai would earn a reputation within the Imperium as a truly deadly warrior. Rogal Dorn and Rebute Gilliman would object to the Khan's swift induction into the theatre of war, believing the Primarch to lack true understanding of the Imperium's values and culture, leaving him ill-prepared to integrate into the wider Imperium. Though the Khan did have strong bonds with some of his brothers, notably Horus Lupercal and Magnus the Red of the Thousand Sons, as the first Primarch to meet the Khan, Horus would revel in their shared exploits and respect for one another as warriors. Whilst Magnus was an outsider to his brothers just like the Khan and shared a kinship for the pursuit of knowledge. It was therefore tragic that his most erstwhile brothers would one day be his enemies. With the beginning stages of the Horus heresy, Horus would turn to Jaghatai for his allegiance. However, his loyalty to the Emperor was unbreakable, and the Khan would stay his hand. Jaghatai would not dive into the conflict, instead waiting patiently for information to be relayed to him. Even when being petitioned for aid by Leman Russ of the Space Wolves to combat the traitor forces of the Alpha Legion, the Khan would receive conflicting reports from several legions, but wisely not involve himself until he knew the truth of the events that had unfolded. Seeking answers, the Khan would receive urgent orders from Rogal Dorn himself, requesting for the White Scars to immediately travel to Holy Terra to aid in its defense. The Alpha Legion would blockade his passage, presenting themselves neither as friend or foe. The Khan would assess their ruse, realizing their actions sought to sow doubt in his mind, keeping the White Scars immobile and neutered in the wider war that was waging. The Khan's fleet would confront the Alpha Legion blockade, which would result in the Alpha Legion firing on their vessels. The 20th Legion, renowned for their secrecy, would be bested by the Khan's cunning, and the White Scars would push past the blockade and travel into warp space, their destination unknown. The 5th Legion would find themselves at Prospero, its surface scorched to the consistency of burnt charcoal. On the surface, the Khan would speak with an apparition of his beloved brother, Magnus the Red. He explained that he had tried to warn the Emperor of Horus's betrayal, but was punished for his intervention. When pressed for his allegiance, Magnus would reveal his opposition to the Emperor, and the Khan would stand with the Imperium. Feeling a presence that had haunted him since Ulanor, the Khan would witness a spear of light pierce the sky of Prospero, summoning the Primarch of the Death Guard, Mortarion. The Primarch of the 14th Legion would implore the Khan to join Horus's traitor legions. Noticing the physical changes to his brother, the Khan would warn Mortarion of further changes that might befall his legion should he continue to pursue his corrupted path. Mortarion would brush aside his warnings, and with the Khan's refusal to join the traitors, the two Primarchs would duel. Their battle would end in stalemate, with the cowardly Mortarion retreating before the battle could be finished. With his interactions between Magnus and Mortarion concluded, Jaghatai had finally deduced the extent of the traitorous intent of Horus Lupercal's rebellion. Resolving to aid his brother Primarch Rogal Dorn in the defense of Terra, the Khan would utilize the Dark Glass, a relic from the Dark Age of Technology recently discovered by rogue traders. White Scar veteran Targutai Yusuge would sacrifice his life to power the relic and allow the Khan to travel to Terra. Meeting with Rogal Dorn, Sanguinius, and Malkador the Sigillite, the assembled protectors of Terra would devise their strategy to combat the incoming traitor forces. With the full force of chaos assaulting the Imperial Palace, Jaghatai Khan would aid the beleaguered defenders of the throne by recovering the vital Lionsgate spaceport from traitor forces, using his strategies of lightning-fast raid tactics, reclaiming the spaceport in a tremendous single strike. Jaghatai would also lead his 300-strong jetbike battalion to assault the Colossi Gate with support from Blood Angel Captain Rauderon and Adeptus Custodes Commander, Constantine Valdor. This retaliation would be halted by the arrival of the Death Guard, with the now fully chaos-corrupted Primarch Mortarion dueling Jaghatai once again. Their rematch would prove that Jaghatai was no match in strength for the now empowered Primarch of the 14th Legion. However, the Khan understood the psychology of his brother and baited him with barbed words and insults that played to his neuroticism. Overextending Mortarion, he would reveal a weakness for the Khan to exploit. As Jaghatai was impaled by Mortarion's scythe, the Khan would behead his former brother, casting his soul into the warp. After recovering from his wounds and with the Horus Heresy quashed under the heel of his Imperium, Jaghatai Khan would return to Chogoris. Finding that the Dark Eldar had made several raids on his homeworld, the Khan would hunt down the Drukhari, even pursuing his charge into the Webway to bring an end to their foul deeds. To which he has since not returned, though it is said amongst the veterans of the White Scars that the Great Khan will one day return to his legion, in the time of their greatest need, and bring righteous fury to the enemies of his Imperium.
It is not enough to take from an enemy their life, rather, take from them also their places of safety, their allies, their homes, and their loved ones. Crush all those in their care, lay their chattels to waste, and then drive them alone and naked into the darkness. Take everything they have and burn it for the mere pleasure of seeing the ash crackle between your fingers, and call it nothing more than a beginning.
This has been a tale of the Great Imperium of Man, read by the Remembrancer. Bare your teeth, sons of Fenris, for our next Vox transmission, wherein we will detail the deeds of the Great Wolf, Lehman Russ.